Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with the lead editorial. Now today's lead editorial is very important from GS paper 3 point of view, and primarily it deals with defense. Now what is this editorial about? Now this editorial primarily deals with the expenditure that we are doing in the defense sector. This editorial has delved deep in the aspect of the spending that we are doing on the defense. Now, whether that spending is enough or whether that spending is less. Now, in the recent budget of the government, the government has increased the allocation of on the defense sector, but in absolute terms, it is less in comparison to China. And it is very less in comparison to United States of America. So the defense allocation is less, and that is the reason the forces, they are actually trying to exert pressure on the Indian government to increase the spending in the defense sector. Now when it comes to defense sector, when it comes to the spending on the defense sector, it is only the one issue. There are multiple other issues attached with the defense sector. The first is about the spending. The spending that we are doing, it is actually less. And secondly, the important thing is with respect to defense procurement. That is another issue crippling the defense sector. Now, how we are procuring the defense gadgetry from the foreign in India. Now, when it comes to the defense procurement, we have a defense policy 2016, defense procurement policy. Now, as per that policy, we have created standards by which we are trying to focus more on the manufacturing that should be taking place in India. And primarily, we have also introduced offset clause. Now, this is very important, offset clause. So, this is the very important thing that has recently been introduced in the defense policy. Now already we had this defense offset clause in the defense policy, but this has been modified. Now what is this defense offset clause? We need to understand this too, and after that we will be moving to understand the spending that we are doing on the defense sector. Now offset clause, what it means? It means if some foreign company from whom we are procuring the defense gadgetry, and if that defense gadgetry cost is to the limit of 2000 crore rupees, in that case 30% of the procurement, that particular company from which we are procuring the defense gadgetry, should be procuring it from indigenous sources, that is from Indian sources. Now this offset clause has been introduced in the defense sector in order to promote indigenous development of the defense sector of India, indigenous manufacturing of defense gadgetry. Secondly, like I have told you, this defense sector is crippling with numerous issues. First of all, the issue is with respect to the manufacturing, indigenous manufacturing. And secondly, another important thing is with respect to foreign direct investment. Now with respect to FDI in the defense sector, government has recently allowed 100% of FDI in India. 49% is by the automatic route, and beyond 49% there will be a need to take permission from the government of India. Now this is with respect to FDI, this is with respect to production, and in production focusing on creating up an atmosphere by which you try to promote the manufacturing that should be done by the indigenous players. Now thirdly, another very important thing is with respect to licensing. Now with respect to licensing, earlier the license for the defense production was given for 3 years, but the government of India has brought about a change recently whereby you will get this license for 15 years. Then the fourth important change that has been done in the defense sector is with respect to the involvement of the private sector. Private sector. The government is ready to engage with the private sector. Plus, government has also allowed the foreigner players to engage with the private sector. The foreign player engagement with the private sector and government's engagement with the private sector, that is public private partnership, it has also unfolded in the defense sector. So broadly, these are the changes that the defense sector, Indian defense sector, has witnessed recently. Now, another important thing apart from these is that the government of India is focusing more and more on indigenous design, development and manufacturing of the defense gadgetry. Now, this is very, very important. Now, why I am focusing so much on the indigenous aspect? Like in the offset, again, I have talked about indigenous aspects. Indigenous design, development and manufacture, again, I have talked about indigenous development. In private sector, again, I have talked about the indigenous focus. And in licensing, again, like the license period has been increased to 15 years. I have indirectly focused on the indigenous aspect in the defense sector. The reason for that is, now when it comes to the total spending that is done on the defense sector, 60% of it is done on capital investment in the defense sector. Now, what is meant by 60% in the defense sector capital investment? Iska kya matlab hai? It means that the government, whatever amount it is spending on the defense, out of that 60% of the amount is spent on the purchases, like for buying tanks, for buying missiles, for buying ammunition. So government is buying all these products, and all these products, out of the 60% that the spending that the government is doing on the capital aspect, out of it 60% is from import. Now, very important thing, very important fact about the defense sector of India, that the in the Indian defense system, we are actually depending upon the import of the defense gadgetry. We are not manufacturing it. We are not indigenously developing it. We are just buying it from the companies who are designing it, who are developing it, who are manufacturing it outside of India. So that is the reason that the government has completely altered its policy in the last 10 years, 15 years, and it has introduced the offset clause, it has liberalized FDI, it has liberalized licensing, it has invited the private sector, and it has focused on indigenous design development and manufacturing. So as far as today's editorial is concerned, it is about that we are spending less in comparison to China on the defense sector, and the spending on the defense sector should actually be increased. And the reason for that is, in case of India, like, we are having acrimonious relationship with the two countries, one is China and the other is Pakistan, and if there might be a situation in which we will be required to fight against China and Pakistan simultaneously, it will be troublesome for India. And so there is a need to spend more on the defense. There is a need to import more defense gadgetry. But just importing the defense gadgetry, buying the defense gadgetry alone is not the solution. We need to increase research and development in the defense sector. Like DRDO is concerned, DRDO hasn't done much when it comes to producing state-of-the-art technology in the defense sector. We still are buying small arms weapons from the foreign countries. India has not even been able to develop its own pistol or short arms, small arms. So this was all for the editorial Decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brain EIAS. And you can also contact us at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in joining the offline classes and you're interested in buying the online courses. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brain EIAS. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.